going on? It's Fernudo, and welcome back to another episode of Fixing Subscribers FLPs. So in this episode, I got three that I'm going to be fixing, and yeah, let's get right into it. So the first one I got is from somebody named Freeze or something like that, and it's called Slat Number 8, and yeah, let's take a listen. Alright, so that was pretty good. I'm actually going to try to flip the sample a little bit differently here just to see how it sounds. And yeah, we're going to do some things to it. So I like that way more. I feel like that's a lot simpler and it's a lot more catchy. It's a little bit repetitive, but I think an artist would definitely prefer that. See this 808 pattern, pitch it up one obviously because I pitched the sample up, but I'm gonna get rid of this bell. Let's go ahead and just do this. Kind of made the pattern a little bit more predictable. I added this C down here because I think that's in the progression itself, so I wanted to just make the 808 resolve. And yeah, so I like that 808 a lot more. So let's just see what else we got going on here. Let's listen to the drums. All right, right off the bat, I don't like that. I think a big thing with hi-hats is you want to make them pretty predictable, so even repeating a two-bar loop is good, even if you just change it at the end for a little bit of variance. I just don't like having two things that are completely different in a four-bar span. I just don't think it makes sense, but that's just... There it is. It's all about trial and error. If you fail, you know, keep going. You will. It is easy to correct things like that. You just got to keep listening to it. Pitch the 808 up. So, yo, that's going to do it for Freeze's FLP here, and I'll see you in the next one. All right, so this next one we got is by Jay Sewell, and it is called Immaculate. So let's take a listen here. Damn. So those drums are not hitting. We're going to scrap these drums and we're going to create a new pattern. So we got pattern one here. It's already made for us. And I'm going to use this section of the loop here. I really like the way that this sounded. And yeah, I'm just going to basically do a complete overhaul of these drums because those were not hitting. But we could definitely make them hit because this melody is fire. I don't know if he made this sample or somebody else did. But yeah, we're just going to load up some drums. So we're going to do some simple 808 pattern here, or not 808, hi-hat, because I'm not a fan of overcomplicating hi-hat patterns with a melody this complex. Right off the bat, there's way more groove in this, and it's letting the melody really shine because we've got hard-hitting drums. They go hand in hand, you know. A lot of people think it's just the drums, but if your drums are off, your melody's not going to shine, and vice versa. So we're going to add this 808 now and let's see how it goes. We're going to pitch it just one, just because I want the 808 to be a little less muddy. General rule of thumb I like to follow is don't go below A4. But in this one, I'm going to stick to B. So another thing to keep bounce and groove constant in your beat is don't overcomplicate the 808s. Like I did not have a lot of 808s hitting at all, but that's because the drums are really carrying the percussion. So I kept the 808 pretty spaced and which allowed for a nice predictable groove. So that's going to do it for Immaculate by Jay Sewell. Let's get into the third one. So this third one we got is by a guy named Nate Mosa. Looks like the loop is called Prime. So let's take a listen. So that's really hard. I definitely think this is one of the best ones I've found so far out of the three. But there are some things I definitely want to change. So yeah, let's get right into it. So right off the bat, this melody is not, I don't think it's EQ'd properly. So I'm gonna go ahead and look at this. It's So sometimes a hard roll off like that can cause some muddiness at the roll off because this is so strong. So I like to keep it at this. I just like to move it up further. I don't like the when you change the bandwidth or whatever it is. I just prefer to have a normal curve like this. And I just lower it like this if I need to. I'm gonna lower the area where the artist that would get on this beat vocals would be. So usually around the mid to high mid. For this one, I'm gonna lower the treble a little bit. And I'm gonna add some RC20. So this is with the effects, without it, sounds like this. No. Definitely gonna be way easier for drums to sit on it. So now we're gonna go ahead and look at everything else here. So I'm gonna start with the hi-hats. I just don't like that sound. I think it's a little too tight and small, so I'm gonna replace it with the bowl hi-hat. Tighten this up. I'm actually going to change this with something that hits a little bit quicker, so like this. That opens way more groove. Perk here. So we really just simplified the drums, to be honest with you, and now we're going to get into the 808s just to see what to do here. So we got this. Oh, this is another. Definitely like the way that's sounding. It's adding some more groove. So this is just really a louder, just a boost. This, that's all this is, just the Z808. So we're just going to tighten it up. All right, I'm going to add some effects here. I'm not a big fan of the soft clippers on the 808. I'd rather just keep it under control. I think I'm going to add a little bit of distortion on this just to kind of like brighten up the 808. I want some of the high ends to shine. So I use some oomph, but I'm just going to lower it a little bit. So right off the bat, that sounded out of key. So going up. That's going to do it for Nate Moses' beat. I think I made this one a lot more groovy. Definitely allowed for a little bit more space, simplified things. I like to keep it real simple. So in these videos, you're really going to see me kind of dumb some things down, whatever you want to call it, just to kind of make things way more easy for an artist to listen to it and rap over. So, yeah.